Kaufman, the travel mom.
And I really enjoy wine. However, the truth is, I don't know that much about it. So I've come to Sonoma County in California, home to some of the best wines in the entire world, so I can learn more.
Let's go explore Sonoma County.
The first thing that's going to happen for us is the grapevines are going to begin to wake up. You might see the vines starting to go through bud break.
How much time between seeing this first bud break to the time it's bottled?
It depends on the wine, but yeah, at least a year.
Essentially, the grapes are harvested in the beginning and the end of August, September into October.
We are going to sort through the grapes and make sure that what we are using is of the best quality.
The winemaker determines the picking time based on tasting the grapes and the degree of sugar. And different grapes ripen at different times.
It all starts out in the fields, in the vineyards. If we can grow the best grapes, we make a better wine.
Over here we have the sorting table. The fruit comes in from the fields in plastic bins, gets thrown into this, comes out on this sorting table, and we have crew to kind of pick out the moldy grapes, the overripe grapes, the raisiny grapes. We'll put them over in the crusher destemmer.
This is a crusher stemmer, and this screw pushes the grapes up the conveyor belt.
During harvest, this is where all of the excitement is right over here.
Let's go check out where the wine is made.
These tanks are huge. What goes on here?
Well, this is where the grape juice is fermented and eventually will be made into wine.
The simple conversion of sugar to alcohol. Grapes may be in here a total of 4, maybe up to 5 weeks. So they're gonna slowly crush themselves under their own weight inside this tank.
The difference between red wines and white wines is red wines are fermented on the skins and white wines aren't.
We're gonna cover it with just one of these canvas covers here. This helps to keep what we call MOG out of the tank. MOG stands for material other than grapes. Next step would be to drain the wine out into oak barrels.
There are a myriad of different barrels that wine can be aged in.
Oh, here he's doing the barrels back here.
Right here, what Jose is doing is topping our barrels, and topping means adding a little bit of wine to replace what has evaporated during the barrel aging process.
So we are in the barrel room right now where all the wine is slowly aging to perfection. The smell we're getting in here is what we might call the angel share, which is the wine that is evaporating out through these barrels and is essentially in the air.
Good job.
And if it's a white wine, they're fermented in the tanks and they never see a barrel.
And then after about a year, anywhere from 10 to 12 months, they'll be ready to be bottled.
The bottles would be emptied onto this conveyor belt. The bottles would come down here. They would be filled by this machine. The cork is put in here. This machine over here spins the capsule on. And then they go off over here, and the label is put on right there. The bottles twirl around, the labels go on, and they come off right here. And we have people at the end of the bottling line that make sure that the labels are straight and the capsules are on perfectly. They pack the bottles into the cartons, and then away they go to be shipped away.
They'll spend another 10 to 12 months in the bottle, and then they're ready for sale.